Okay. Stellina has initialized. We're going to look for. Oh, come on. To look for a target, and I want M101. And let's observe it. In the meantime, we have to initialize our good friend here, the dwarf tube, and one second exposures, and gain of about 80 should give us good calibration. Okay, and let us calibrate. First calculation is good. Second calibration. All right, Stellina is already capturing. And we have calibrated successfully. Let's find a target. We're going to go with the same target. And there's M101. Confirm. Let's see. Okay, we're just going to start stacking. In the meantime, I need to find out why Stellina is not displaying what it is stacking. Okay, Stellina has gone berserk on me. Absolutely no reason not to display what it is stacking. All right, I'm gonna. Try to restart autofocus. Nope, it says it's continuous. All right, then let's stop it and restart it. It says it is autofocusing. It took a while to set up both machines. And ever since the latest update on Stellina, it has not been acting nice on me. In the meantime, DWARF 2 has already stacked 34 frames. It's dropping about half of them for some reason. We'll go back to Stellina as soon as it's done refocusing. The wind has picked up outside. All right, it has autofocused. Let's see if it let us go to the top of the elevation. And let's see if we can go again to the Belladonna galaxy. All right. Looks like I'm going to go for another target on Stellina. Okay, Stellina is misbehaving majorly, leaving me no choice but to reinitialize. We will not consider that as part of the comparison, although it should be. Reinitialize. I'm going to change network connection to Stellina. I have a Wi-Fi repeater booster, so we'll see if that will make a difference. Alright, let us try initialization again. In the meantime, let's see what the dwarf is doing. There's a little bit too much red in it. I'm going to stop it and see if the IR, the infrared filter, is on or not. Doesn't like me either. Well, I'm going to go and physically reset both devices and see why they are not happy. Let me start by resetting DWARF. Let's see if it will reset on its own. Okay. That's that with DWARF. Let's reboot. Okay, so far so good. Wide angle lens is open. Let's go to Astro. And I want IR cut. One second exposure. Gain of 80. And let's see if it calibrates happily. It makes a full 360 degree spin. Takes a first screenshot or shot of the sky. Does the plate solving. Second one. And third one. Okay. Looks like we're making progress here. Successful calibration. Already. Let's do an auto go to. My plan was to look at M101. Confirm. And it has succeeded. Might as well start capturing. This will capture and stack at the same time. And it shows up there in the corner. Frames captured and frames stacked. I'm gonna go outside and restart Stellina. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Strangest thing, Stellina's arm was opening and closing and opening and closing and opening and closing. Let's see if it's gonna let me initialize now. Stellina is utterly unhappy tonight. Keeps telling me product not connected. To attempt to turn off the Wi-Fi completely and turn it back on, see if that makes any difference. Let's hope that DWARF is a bit more resilient and does not lose me when I turn off the Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is off. Wi-Fi is on. DWARF is still stacking. Stellina has connected and thinks that it's initializing. Connect, disconnect, connect, disconnect. All right, let's... gonna shut down the app and restart it. That's cleared. Singularity. Initialization in progress. That's another valid comparison between Stellina and DWARF 2. Stellina takes a few minutes to initialize. DWARF 2 takes a few seconds to initialize. Star zone search. The plate solving on DWARF is, again, an order of magnitude faster than on Stellina. And the autofocus on DWARF is almost instantaneous. On Stellina, it's a couple minutes. All right, Stellina has started autofocus. One of the things that I saw at the Northeast Astronomy Forum yesterday, it was extremely tempting, is the Rockland Astronomy Club was selling used equipment, including a reasonably nice telescope with mount and tripod for $50. Was very tempted to carry one back home. But realizing that I have my hands full with five different systems right now, I don't need another one. The learning curve on DWARF 2 has been slightly steeper than I expected it to be, but it has been a lot less frustrating than Stellina. The quality of the image that Stellina gives is obviously far superior to DWARF. We're talking about a 3-inch lens versus a 1-inch lens. Autofocus is still going on. It has been going on for 2 minutes now. The autofocus on DWARF is almost instantaneous. Point to a target, double click on it, and it goes zoom, zoom, and we're done. Okay, initialization is successful on Stellina. Look for a target. And we're gonna go to M101. It is checking position accuracy. That's English for plate solving. And this is where the frustration began earlier this evening. It would not display the stacked image. Let's hope that this time it will redeem itself and display the stacked images. In the meantime, DWARF 2 has stacked 208 out of 348 frames. Not sure why it's dropping so many. In case you don't realize it, but DWARF weighs 1/10 the weight of Stellina. Stellina is 24 pounds, DWARF is 2.4 pounds. It opens up a few possibilities when a telescope is that light. Capture has started on the Pinwheel Galaxy. And please show me stars and not a black screen. Come on. Stellina is just not happy tonight. I'll leave Stellina alone and attempt something else. I'm going to open another instance of BlueStacks. And try to connect Stellina as an observer and see if that will let me display what's happening. Now, it's going to be displaying a blue circle that's going around and around. Okay, the experiment of comparing the two I'm not gonna call it an utter failure because it was indeed a comparison. And it behooves me at this point to salvage the light by staying with the DWARF 2 until it finishes its observation. This is another interesting feature of DWARF 2 that Stellina does not have, and that is the ability to manipulate the histogram. I wish I knew how to overlap the three colors. Uh-oh, that's all they have in mind. Okay, I'm going to try to put all of them right on top of the first dotted line. Okay, let's see if we move the lower one. It doesn't want to move. Okay, I have to understand that idea of histogram manipulation. Set. Red. Unable to move the peak to where I want it. That is unfortunate. It's a very useful tool otherwise. All I want to be able to do is to move those three peaks, to put them on top of each other. So here they are, I just need them on top of each other. It's letting me move the red. That gives some effect. I can move the green also, not that much. Reset the green. Whatever. I'm going to bring Stellina inside. Be right back. Stellina is safely indoors, and we're going to have a talk next time the sky is clear to find out why Singularity did not display the images that Stellina claims to be capturing. Back to DWARF for a moment. As you can tell, there is obvious field rotation. I attempted to mount DWARF on an equatorial mount, and that took care of the field rotation. I'm wondering now if the streaks around the target are also an artifact of the field rotation or not. And whether restacking the images will eliminate that problem. I'll be processing the TIFF later on. One big concern I have with mounting the DWARF on an equatorial mount is that it puts undue stress on the bearings that are supposed to be vertical and not at 45 degree angle. So I don't know whether that's going to cause damage, premature damage to the bearings of the azimuth axis of rotation on the telescope. I'm still experimenting with it, so we'll find out what it will do eventually. Yeah, this is the first time that I have such obvious streaks that may or may not be caused by the field rotation. Trying to get the colors as close to white as possible, and I don't seem to be having much success. The colors of the stars. At this point, it's probably best to call it a night. And I'm going to go find out what's up with Stellina. I wonder if it's simply sibling rivalry at this point with the new baby in the house. Stellina is refusing to work. It's approaching 10 p.m. on the east coast of the U.S. I wish you all a good night. Thank you for joining me. The forecast for the next few days is cloudy, but that would not prevent me from putting one telescope or the other out whenever there is a break in the cloud. Especially in the morning, there is a chance that we might see some sun. Other than that, so long from the Rooster Inn.